In this video, we'll discuss hydrostatic tests and explain the difference between a functional pressure test, proof testing, burst testing, and fatigue testing. Hydrostatic testing is the process of pressure testing with a liquid, often water, to verify the integrity of a system or component. Any pressurised vessel, reservoir, hose, or hydraulic system component, like a valve or accumulator, has to be designed, manufactured, and one day repaired to work at a pressure. Hydrostatic pressure testing provides additional confidence that a component or system are safe. So, on to the tests. A functional pressure test tests components to a maximum working or operating pressure, as well as lower pressures. This emulates the way a user would typically operate the equipment and provides confidence that it will work for the end user day after day. The easiest way to carry out a functional pressure test is to connect a hydraulic hand pump and pump up to the maximum working pressure. The pressure will be recorded on a pressure gauge. You should expect it to work and not leak or deform. And while a maximum working pressure is absolutely essential, it's worth noting that some parts perform at high pressures, but could display problems at low pressures. Contamination or damage on a seal might only be evident at low pressures. To check this, pump to low pressure and check for leaks or operational issues. Nothing should be designed to operate just on the edge of failing. There has to be a safety margin. This is where a hydrostatic proof test comes in. This test takes the maximum working pressure plus a safety factor, for example, times 1.5, to create a proof pressure. This is overloading the part beyond the expected use, making sure that the part can stay functional even over its rated pressure. The simplest way to carry out a hydrostatic proof test is to increase the pressure up to the proof pressure, and after a period, you check that there is no leakage or permanent deformation. Now, let's talk about burst testing. A hydrostatic burst test raises the pressure until the part fails and bursts. This is an extreme test, and the part is destroyed in the process. For safety, make sure the component or system is in a burst protection chamber or behind a screen. As failure will likely happen very suddenly, the simplest and cheapest equipment is a hand pump fitted with a drag pointer pressure gauge or an electronic gauge with maximum pressure recording. To carry out a burst test, pump to increase the pressure and record the pressure at which it bursts. Lastly, for a fatigue pressure test, the component or system is taken up to pressure, back down to zero, and repeated many times. This is the most difficult test to design, as unless the parameters are written in regulations, an engineer will need to decide what is useful. This is the simplest program of testing and can be achieved at low cost with equipment like our PTR programmable pressure test rig. You can run up to 290 bar and 200,000 cycles. This is a low-tech and inexpensive way to complete fatigue pressure testing. If you need something more sophisticated to carry out a complicated test, you'll need a custom rig. This can be expensive equipment. At Sarum Hydraulics, we have 35 years' experience in supplying hydraulic pumps for every sort of hydrostatic test. Whether it's one of our range of catalogue hand pumps and reservoirs or our programmable PTR cycle test units, we are always interested in talking to you about your testing applications. Click the link in the description for our in-depth write-up on the subject, covering the Pressure Equipment Directive, Pressure System Safety Regulations, Statistical Pressure Control, and more.